the Father.
We believe in God the Father.
We believe in Christ the
Son. Join us.
We
believe in Christ the Son.
We believe in the Holy Spirit.
We believe in the Holy Spirit.
We are the church and we stand as one.
We are the church and we stand as one.
Holy,
in the name of the Lord. Welcome to First Presbyterian Church. If you're visiting, welcome. If you're in person, welcome. If you're online, we appreciate you being with us. What a celebratory weekend here at FPC. We had our celebration last night of 75 years. This is the actual day of our 75th anniversary. 75 years ago, we started worshiping here. Incredible. I want to thank all those who were involved as far as participants, as far as planning. So if you were involved in any way, please raise your hand or just stand up if you can. And we'd like to thank you. Especially Joe Wilson, who chaired the committee. awesome. We will have more celebration following worship. I think we have cake. I'm always for dessert, as I said last night. Cake first, right? All right, we have a few announcements. We have the one great hour of sharing we have during our Easter time. We now have the fish banks on the credenzas. For those who are kids or kid at heart, we have those available for you to color. Return those next Sunday, and we'll do a nice dedication for that. Easter egg hunt. What is Easter without an Easter egg hunt, right? We're having that following worship next Sunday. We're asking for no chocolate. Can I have a, No chocolates, just because they will melt out there. So yeah, we can have chocolates other time, but no chocolates next Sunday. All right, if you would like to donate pre-filled Easter eggs, we do have a barrel right over there at the front doors, and also in the office. We'll collect those throughout the week. And the Sunday after Easter, we have our Youth Sunday. So if you're a youth, junior high or senior high, come to the youth room, and we're going to be planning an awesome service. I think we have the praise band also that weekend. So we have that happening. And hope to see everyone here back next Sunday for our Easter service at 10 a.m. And Thursday, we have the Monday Thursday service, Thursday night at 7 p.m. I think that's all the announcements, right, David? Other than, we're going to have, after the call to worship, we're going to have a little processional with the opening hymn. I have palms over here for the kiddos. Dan, if you can wave, if any kiddos out in the congregation wants to be part of, follow me to the doors. And during the processional, we're going to have our annual parade, our Palm Sunday parade. All right, let us prepare our hearts, souls, and mind for worship.
Let us call ourselves to worship. May I invite you to stand in body or in spirit as we do so. The King comes among us. Blessed is he who comes. He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Let us worship God. All glory, Lord, and honor, our opening hymn. Thank you. Please remain standing for the prayer of adoration. Let us pray. All glory, Lord, and honor to you, O Christ, we raise. We praise you for choosing to come among us. We praise you for sharing your own eternal life with us. We praise you for inviting us to be with you in your heavenly kingdom. We now sing praise with the music of our lives, with the demonstrations of our faith, with expressions of our hope, with experiences of your love. May your sacred purpose unfold in our lives, O Lord, and may our loyalty and devotion to your sovereign reign be evident in a world of chaos, and to you be all glory, Lord, and honor now and always. Amen. Please be seated.
Now for the confessional hat. Let us prepare for the morning confessional. We sing, we wave our branches, we shout Hosanna, and then we turn away to go back to our old ways, our old lives, and our old sins. But God is in the business of granting forgiveness and filling us with new life. Let us confess to the one who comes to fill us with that grace. Let us pray. With eager hearts and open hands, Holy One, we welcome Jesus until he refuses the power we offer him. Choosing to become our servant, we pick up the faith we had laid on the ground before him and put it back on the shelf where it belongs. Our heart keeps us from being able to follow him all the way to Calvary. Hosanna, steadfast God, save us. Help us to let our fears and our doubts and our faithfulness slip away in our eyes. O God, may be free. So that we can know our Savior, Jesus Christ, who comes in your name, in your glory, grace, save us. Now hear these words of assurance. Friends of Jesus, we are made clean by the words he has spoken to us. There is room in our lives and in our community for the Holy One to dwell within us. Thanks be to God. Amen. I'd like to invite the children now to come forward for a children's sermon, a very special story today. Good morning. Good to see each and every one of you, and all of you as well. We are indeed children of God, aren't we? Well, what is today? We just had a parade. Why do we have a parade?
Palm Day.
Palm Sunday. It's one of those days, right? Palm Sunday. What happens with Palm Sunday? What's the big deal with it?
Children go around the church and use palms.
Uh-huh. What happened a long time ago on this day? Who went into Jerusalem and they celebrated? Yes?
Jesus
came in. Yes, and this is right before he actually, this is called Holy Week, and this is right before his most important thing that he does for us. What happens on Good Friday? He goes to the
cross.
Yes. And does he come back? What day does he come back?
Friday.
He comes back on Sunday. He is risen on Sunday. He died for our sin. Thanks be to God. Well, I have a story here. Cute story. It's called Howie's Broken Hee-Haw. And this is, yeah, that's what a donkey sound goes. Congregation, can we do it together? 1, 2, 3.
Hee-Haw.
There we go. And this was a very special donkey who had a broken hee-haw, and we'll see what happens in the story. Hee-haw, hee-haw, la la, hallelujah! Little Howie stomped his hooves in anger. He never would be able to hee-haw, hee-haw like the other colts. His second hee-haw always turned into hee-haw, la la, hallelujahs. Too loud for you? Blame it on the soundboard. Howie practiced every day, but he just couldn't get it right. He felt like he didn't have control of his own mouth, and that made him mad. Have you had one of those days that things aren't going right for you?
Even at school.
Hee-haw, hee-haw, hallelujah, hee-haw, hee-haw, lay-hoo-la-hoo-la. Mama, my hee-haw is still broken. That's enough practice for Nat today, Howie. It's your bedtime, Mama said, with a kiss to his forehead. You can try again tomorrow. Sweet dreams, my dear, and remember, I love you so very much. Howie didn't want to go back to bed, but he had to admit he was sleepy. All that practice tired him out. With a big sigh, he curled up in the hay. Giant tears rolled down his furry snout. He snuggled deeper into the hay, drying his tears and telling himself tomorrow would be a better day. Come along, Howie, we have to go. What's happening, Mama? I'm not sure, but these men have come to take us somewhere. Hurry up now. They're waiting for us.
Maybe they're taking him to a
better place. Yeah, let's find out. Howie stayed close to his mama as they walked and walked and walked. Mama's right beside him. There's Mama, there's Howie. Hee-haw, hee-haw, lay-lay-loo-yah, Howie whispered, his broken hee-haw. He wanted to practice, but he didn't want the men to hear him. He was ashamed of his hee-haw, wasn't he? Well, 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 who do we have here? A kind man asked. Hello, sir. My name is Howie. Well, hello, Howie. My name is Jesus. and I need your help today.
Why does it say to help?
You need my help? Howie asked. How can I help you? I'm just a donkey with a broken hee-hawer. There's lots of donkeys who can help, can do a much better job than I can. And Jesus takes him for a walk. Oh, little one, you're not broken. You're perfect, just the way you are. I am? Yeah, sure. I chose you to ride in Jerusalem because I have need of your special hee-haw. Jesus whispered, I don't know if I can do it, he whispered to Jesus. I don't know if I can do it. What if everyone laughs at my funny hee-hawer? I'm scared. Jesus wrapped his arms around Howie and whispered in his ear, Howie, what did that man say to you? Asked Mama. Mama, that man is Jesus. He told me that he needs me today. I'm going to carry him into Jerusalem, and he didn't care at all about my hee-hawer is broken. He said my hee-haw, yee-la-lee-loo-la, is a special one, and that I was made to praise him. And just that way he did, how he carried Jesus down the dusty road into Jerusalem. As they neared the city, how he saw crowds of people coming out to meet them. And his legs began to shake. Jesus scratched behind Howie's ears and said, Don't be afraid, little one. Now the time to use your special bray is now. With that, Howie bellowed that loud as he can, hee-haw, hee-haw, lay-lay-loo-la, he could muster. Hee-haw, hee-haw, lay-loo-la. Howie's beautiful hee-haw was heard about the crowds of the people surrounding Jesus. They laughed in delight at Howie's song of praise and added their own cries of Hosanna in the highest as Howie and Jesus passed their way. Joy filled Howie's heart because he knew he was made on purpose, for a purpose. Just like each one of us, we are made in God's image for a purpose, and we're all special in God's eyes. We're beautifully and wonderfully made. Would you pray with me? God, be in my head. God, be in my heart. God, be in my left. God, be in my right. God, be beneath me. God, be above me. God, be upon the faces of all those around me who loves me, and God loves you regardless. Amen. All right, let's go back to our seats. Thank you so much for allowing me to share that special story.
Let's pray. Holy Triune God, illumine your word for us that it might be shining deep within our very being, so that the people around us might see the love we have for you and understand why we share it with them. I pray these things in Christ's name. Amen. This morning's scripture comes from Luke 19, verses 28 through 40. After he had said this, he went on ahead, going up to Jerusalem. When he had come near Bethpage and Bethany, at the place called Mount of Olives, he sent two of the disciples, saying, Go into the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, why are you untying it? Just say this, the Lord needs it. So those who were sent departed and found it as he had told them. As they were untying the colt, its owner asked them, "Why are you untying the colt?" And they said, "The Lord needs it." And then they brought it to Jesus. After throwing their cloaks on the colt, they set Jesus on it. As he rode along, people kept spreading their cloaks on the road. As he was now approaching the path down the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of disciples began to praise God joyfully with a loud voice for all the deeds of power that they had seen, saying, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest heaven." Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, "Teacher, order your disciples to stop." He answered, "I tell you, if these were silent, the stones would shout out." This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Wow, are we ever blessed with great music? It comes from a great faith. My text this morning is taken from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 19, verse 40. The words of our King to those tyrants in any age who would try to silence his followers. I tell you, if these were silent, the stones would shout out. Once in days gone by, Israel had no earthly king. They were a nation under God, and God was their heavenly king. But in time, the people of Israel wanted an earthly king, like the nations round about had earthly kings. And they petitioned God for permission to have one. And God kept saying, "You don't need an earthly king. You've got me. You don't need an earthly king. You've got me." But they persisted. Finally, in one of the strangest moments in biblical history, God relented, as in had a change of heart or a change of mind. And God said, "I will let you have an earthly king, but only on two conditions. I get to pick the king, and I get to plan the coronation. I get to pick the king, and I get to plan the coronation." The reason for the first was this. When God went looking for a king, God didn't look for people who were politically connected or economically viable or socially popular or intellectually astute. God went looking for people of great faith because God wanted it to be clear that the reign of the king was implementing the sovereign will of God. The king was God's representative on earth, and the authority for the king to reign on earth came from the sovereignty of God. So God got to pick the king. As for the coronation, God's plans were very specific. The king must not ride to the place of coronation on a horse, the way a military leader would ride in a parade with great pride. The king would ride to his place of coronation on a donkey to reveal his humility before God and the meekness with which he would reign. So it was in antiquity. God chose the king, and the king rode to the place of coronation. And people would line the streets with palm branches, and they would wave them. And some would cast their garments in front of him in order to show their submission to his reign. And they would shout, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." In other words, blessed is the one that God has chosen to come to us and reign over us. In time, however, the politically entrenched, the power brokers of the day, decided that God was in the way. And so they removed all references to God. They stopped referring to the nation as being a nation under God, and they chose who would reign as king. And that's when the nation began to crumble. But that image of a God-chosen king riding to the place of coronation was part of the latent memory of the people. And Jesus knew just what to do to awaken it. As Luke tells the story, he rode to this place of coronation in the holy city, meekly upon a donkey, telling the world that he was the one that God had chosen to be king, and he was riding to his coronation. That's why they grabbed palm branches and waved them, and that's why they shouted, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." In other words, thank God that God has chosen a king once more to represent the sovereign will of God in heaven. At this point, I need to distance myself from what I've been preaching about this text all my life, because I come at it with brand new insight. See, the way traditionally we're taught to interpret the drama of Palm Sunday and Holy Week is that Jesus' idealism was wonderful on Palm Sunday as he awakened the image of God's reign on earth. But on Maundy Thursday and Good Friday, it was crushed by the political powers that be, and the purpose of God was thwarted in a tragedy that made Jesus look like a victim. But on Easter, God came to the rescue, something like that. But I can't go there anymore. This is what I think really happened, and it's exciting. I think Jesus really was riding to his coronation in the holy city, and that Maundy Thursday and Good Friday were preparation for his coronation on Easter as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And I say that because there is nothing about Maundy Thursday and Good Friday that indicates that Jesus felt victimized by the powers that be. He was very much in command and in control. And all the words he spoke from the cross were not the words of a victim, but the words of one claiming victory. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. This day you will be with me in paradise. These aren't the words of a victim. These are the words of one who is on his way to be coronated on Easter morning as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And we know that he reigns, because in every age, and in this one as well, we have experiences of his sovereignty, of his sovereign will over us. In moments of confusion, we receive inspiration. When we pray and put our cares upon the Lord, he responds and answers them. When we face challenges, we find the courage to stand up to them and the encouragement to prevail against them. In every circumstance of a life, when we call upon the sovereign will of God in the life of Christ, our King of Kings and Lord of Lords, he responds. We know that he reigns supreme. The ones who don't know he reigns supreme are those who do not believe in him. Cancel God from your worldview and remove all references to God as God's authority and over us, and you look around the world and it seems like it's going to hell in a handbasket, and there are a lot of people who like it that way. But those of us who have chosen to believe in him see signs of his sovereign will all over the place, every morning, every noon, every evening, every nighttime, indications that the sovereign will of God is revealing itself in the life of Christ, who was coronated on Easter Sunday as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. So that the Lord, who had influence over a few people for a short period of time, could reign over all people everywhere and forever. The Bible ends with a beautiful vision of the reign of Christ as King of Kings. John, as you remember, was condemned to the island of Patmos for believing in Christ. It was the Alcatraz of the ancient world. By day he quarried stone beneath the blistering heat of the sun and the lash of the whip, and at night he laid upon his cot and stared at the sky. After a while he began to have what he thought were hallucinations. He would see things that he sure weren't there, and he wondered if maybe he was losing his mind, or whether maybe because reality was so painful, his mind was escaping into some fantasy world. But the visions kept coming. In the midst of hell, he kept getting visions of heaven, and one of them is extraordinary. They're all extraordinary, but on one that relates to Palm Sunday, it was as if he saw the darkness peeled back from the heavens, and he could look into glory. And he saw Palm Sunday. He saw a multitude greater than anyone could number, made up of people of every race and tribe and nation. And they were all wearing white robes, and they held palm branches in their hands. And they were standing before the throne of the Lamb, and they were saying, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. He shall reign forever and ever, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Hosanna in the highest." It's an image of Palm Sunday in glory. that the Lord who rode into the holy city to be coronated has come to us in every age and in every day the same way, and is honored in glory, in his throne in glory, from which he reigns over all the earth. It's interesting to me that the validating credentials of valid spiritual experience are humility before God, meekness with one another, and joy and rejoicing. Every spiritual experience that we have, if it is authentic, does not lead to experiences of boasting, claims to be better than other people, more saved than other people. Valid spiritual experience leaves us feeling humbled before God and showing meekness to one another and sharing joy from within our hearts. Hearts that are anxious to say, Hosanna, blessed is he who keeps coming to us in the name of the Lord, King of Kings. I don't know about you, but my mind last night, whether I was trying to fall asleep or was actually asleep, kept going through memories of last night. It was an absolutely extraordinary celebration of 75 years. And if you'll notice, all those bearing witness to the beauty of the 75 years, none of them said how proud it made us or how much better it made us than others or how much more exclusive we were as a people. All of them revealed how we are humbled before God, how we live with meekness toward one another, and how we live with hands that are anxious to go where the Lord, to the task to which the Lord assigns them. And in our hearts we sing, glory to God who comes among us, Hosanna in the highest. So my suggestion would be that we wave palm branches, not just one day a year, but all the time. Wave them to passing traffic. Let them wonder what's going on. Let them know that some people are celebrating the sovereignty of our Lord in the midst of a world that has convinced itself that God no longer is relevant or God no longer exists. Wave them in the secret places of your heart if you must. Wave them in the silent, deep places of your mind if you need to. But let us wave them. Let our children know that the sovereignty of God is real for us because we believe in him. And when we believe in him, the evidence abounds that he has indeed been enthroned as King of Kings, King over all kings, and Lord above all lords. Blessed is he who comes among us. Hosanna. He shall reign forever and ever as King of Kings and Lord of lords. Hosanna and hallelujah in the highest. Amen.
I see the King of Glory coming on the clouds with fire, the horn shakes.
I see his love and mercy washing over all our sin. The people sing.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
I see a generation rising up to take their place
with selfless faith.
I see a near revival stirring as we pray and see.
We're on our knees.
Hosanna,
my heart and make it clean.
Open up my eyes to the things unseen. Show me how to love like you have loved me.
Break my heart for what breaks yours.
Everything I am
for your kingdom's cause.
As I walk from earth into eternity.
Hosanna, Hosanna,
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the
Lord God.
Among the things I learned last night, off script, was that once upon a time, Tom used to be the church custodian. And I heard tell that he used to sing as he worked. And I also know that there were many who heard the sound of him singing, even then, and were blessed by it. Thank you. They overheard you praying while you worked. Let us pray. Lord of life and Savior of all, we confess once more that we are guilty of silent discipleship, of choosing not to be confrontational when society needs to be confronted by an authority greater than its own. Forgive, we pray, the silent discipleship that allows injustice to prevail and arrogance to thrive and lethargy to spread unchecked. Before the stones of this present age begin to cry out, make us bold to be the visible instruments of your abiding presence in our time. As you have touched the heart of this congregation with spirit hand, O Lord, so touch each heart here present with healing, with passion, and awaken our minds with creativity and devotion. Give us the new thoughts that will enable us to claim the future in your name, and empower us with your triumphal entry into our midst this day, that our hosannas shouted loud and clear upon the earth may be heard, even by our loved ones in heaven above. Now slip alongside each of us, close enough to hear the whispering of the soul, the longings of the heart, the wanderings of the mind. Then in the cosmic mystery of prayer, receive once more the prayer that we learned from your Son. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Thunder's brightly, oh boy, thunder's brightly. sense of joy, of joy, thy skillful shepherd's band employ to celebrate the glories of this day.
The glory.
The glory.
Tom and Glenn and Mark have given so generously of their talent in this moment, so let us give full measure of our devotion to God. The morning offering is now being received.
Thank you.
We thank you, Lord, for accepting our gifts, the gifts of joy in our hearts, the gifts of commitment in our minds, the gifts of excitement and anticipation in our souls. Accept us as we are, O Lord, and hear our praises. Hosanna on earth and hallelujah in the highest, now and forevermore. Amen. Doesn't know it yet, but I just found a volunteer for the benediction.
Oh, how lovely. Let us go forth now with that spirit of Jesus Christ shining brightly through our hearts as we walk our own individual paths, bringing glory, joy, and honor to everyone we meet, no matter who they are. Jesus lives on through us all. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.